The controversy is the biggest public relations test yet for new Starbucks chief executive Kevin Johnson, who already was fighting to boost traffic to Starbucks amid competition from coffee sellers ranging from hipster cafes to fast food chains and convenience stores. "While this is not limited to Starbucks, we are committed to being a part of the solution," said Johnson, a former technology executive who took the helm about a year ago. "Even if the threatened boycott does not materialize, the 8,000 temporary store closures will almost certainly have an impact on sales." Starbucks did not say how many hours the stores would be shuttered on May 29, but the afternoon is the slowest time for Starbucks business. Starbucks is one of the most high-profile and beloved brands in the world, and its longtime CEO Howard Schultz was not one to shy away from difficult conversations over thorny issues such as gay marriage, gun control, and congressional gridlock. However, U.S. race relations have proven more challenging, even for a company that touts its diverse workforce. Minorities account for 18% of Starbucks executives with the title of senior vice president or higher and 43% of employees overall. For example, the company's 2015 Race Together campaign to foster a conversation on the topic following the high-profile police shootings of several unarmed black men stirred an intense social media backlash. Johnson has apologized for the reprehensible arrests of the two men in Philadelphia on Thursday and took personal responsibility for the incident, which was captured in a customer video that was shared widely.